I do 20 after this. Who's right in the very back that never gets seen, never gets heard? Come on.
Wow. You can project. 25?
All right. Oh, wait a minute. That's why you sit in the back, right? Okay, so choose a number between 1 and 22 in the back. 16? All right, here it is, number 16, coming. Oh, you've seen this. Yeah. But don't you want to know what happened to it and why there wasn't DVD number 5? Yeah, what happened to that? Oh, can't see that. Okay, so Star Child, it is called, was my space mermaid that I did as the demo for the Gnomon DVD. For those of you who haven't seen, anyone hasn't seen this? Okay, quick catch up for you six.
I counted.
Actually, they have this thing they do at Pixar now. Whenever you say yay, which I do all the time, they say boo. So when you say boo, you have to say yay. It totally screws up your... Are you happy? By the way, working for Pixar's just been great. It's been fantastic. Technically, I don't work for Pixar, actually. I work for the people making this top secret film that we can't talk about because they started doing some live action things, and of course, we can't even talk about that. So, But I like the kid looking through the toy store window. I see all these happy people going, yay, boo, boo, yay. And it just looks like the best place to work on Earth. So anyway, if you ever get up there, I think you'll be very lucky people. I'm only there for the summer, and then we'll see what happens once they go into actual production. But for now, it's been fun. Meanwhile, I have DVDs that are due, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Because what I wanted to do with this story, which was Hans Christian Andersen's Little Mermaid, and you take that and reimagine it as a science fiction story. So the mermaids have now all left Earth before we unimagine them. People just don't believe in mermaids anymore, and they started to cease to exist. So they took off. They went into the stars, where they knew they'd be safe. People are never coming up here. Cut to Battlestar Galactica. We're flying through space in big spaceships. What do we find but mermaids? All right, so here they are. This is now the space mermaids. This is Star Child. This is the prince, who is now this grungy-looking space miner, because we're up there, of course, plundering and destroying all the natural resources in space. The witch, remember there's a sea witch that grants, in the Hans Christian Andersen story, it grants her wish to become human so she can go and actually fall in love with this prince properly. And in exchange, he takes away her voice, remember? Mm-hmm. So in space, it's this big, bloated, ball-like thing that inside the space witch lives. You see her in there, that little tongue-like thing? That is actually the space witch. The sea king, her father, who, like all fathers, tries to advise his daughter wisely. Does she listen? No. That's me. I mean, that's him over there. And there at the end, once she gives up her voice, she tries to fall in love with this guy who takes one look at her and he's mesmerized and he loves her, and then asteroids destroy his spaceship. He is then rescued, not by the space mermaid, but by another human, beautiful human woman astronaut whom he falls in love with. And now she's doomed. She's never going to have this guy fall in love with her. So she goes, her sisters appear. The sisters went to the space witch. They cut off all their beautiful hair, and in exchange they got her a laser gun that she can now go and kill him with. And if she does that, she will get her voice back. She'll be able to go back with the mermaids. Everything will be fine. And she's pissed! This guy went off with the other space woman. So she takes that gun and she goes to the wedding in space. They're all floating in space, big long gown being held by droids. She comes flying up to him with the gun and she's going to blast his head off. And he always wears this big helmet, by the way. And the little twist to the story is when she looked in his face and fell in love, what she actually saw was her reflection. She's fallen in love with herself. She's never ever seen him. So she grabs her gun, she runs up, shoves the other woman aside, rips his helmet off, and takes her first look at this guy who is not at all the guy she thought she was in love with. And she sees this look of terror and pain on his face that so echoes her own that she doesn't shoot him. And instead, as she's sitting there just staring at him for the first time, all the guns of the big Earth ships point at her and blast her to atoms.
Wow.
But, as you know, that's so romantic. As you all, it's so romantic. Yeah. I'm getting there! As you know, for all you who are pure of heart and do great, wonderful, self-sacrificing things like that, you get reincarnated as space mermaids. Proper space, actually more space angels. And they appear to take the souls of the dead Earth people off to their proper rewards. And so she becomes a space angel at the end, and everybody lives happily ever after. Okay, so that is, yay, boom! So, that is the story, and I created that story in the first DVD, designed the characters from it in the next three. I promised you number five, which would be the finale. No, five, six, seven, and eight are the finale. Alex is going, what? And what it is I actually want to make this. I want to make it as a short film. I want to submit it to the Academy, and I want to see what happens. And I'm going to do that over the next four DVDs. So you'll get to see this now storyboarded, turned into models and characters, see it animated, see it all put together, see the sound, Skywalker Ranch, everything that happens. I'll walk you through every step of the process. DVD number eight is the film, the final film, and then the actual submission to the Academy. And the wild chance we might win. And then the final result of Iain giving his, well, yes, I actually got to walk up the red carpet and up onto the podium and boop! No! They didn't even look at it. But whatever it is. All right, so, that's what the next ones are. And you can imagine how much time that would take.
Yeah.
So that's why you haven't seen them yet. Meantime, after, oh, this, by the way, is the next section, actually two sections on. The interviewer fell into the dark, and I'm not going to tell you what happened in this horrible place, but it's all the horrific images I've ever drawn. I draw horrific images, by the way. My daughter says I'm as dark as a light bulb, but I have my dark side. By the way, I wore this today to show you I don't always just wear black t-shirts, okay? he goes through this horrific place, and when he's emerges triumphant from that, he goes into this gallery, and it's a private gallery that shows all my top secret projects, Light, Star Child, and you get, it's basically movie trailers. You get to see, I think it's five or six projects that are top secret, but what the heck? Let's show them! So there you are. And at the end of it, there he is, looking, that's the interviewer down there, and he's looking at the picture frame. Oh, and he got a cape. Because of the very heroic thing he did in the previous chapter, he gets his superhero cape. And just as he's looking in there, what should he see but his graphic novel? And it appears in the frame, and it's beautiful. It's exactly what he wanted all of his life, and he is so elated at seeing this thing finally. Remember, he wanted to make his book happen. And then, the next second, he remembers, shit, this is Iain McCaig's studio. What's my book doing in his studio? And right at that moment, Jones gets the phone call. That's Bot, by the way. Bot does everything in the house. Bot does all the work. Everybody ignores him. So he's conveniently become a telephone. Jones gets the call and he goes, hey, the master wants to see you now in the workshop. So that's the end of that chapter. And I think that's enough from that spread. One last one from the last spread, and then I want to show you this top secret thing you're never allowed to see anywhere. All right. 1 to 37.
34.
How about 19? How about 36? Oh, all right. How do we do this properly? I'm going to run. This never happens, right? You always stand up in the front. I'm going to find somebody. Somebody. Yes! Yes! Please give me a number. Between 1 and 37. Yes! My favorite number! Woo! No, I'm serious, 28. Oh, I'll even...